Hey guys, it's Mel here with Body Care Boutique. Yes, it's been forever and I'm feeling it because I miss soaping. So today I'm going to make a soap called Bubble Bath, and I just have the most adorable little embeds that I'm going to use. And it's with a fragrance that's a very clean fragrance. Something that makes you think of soap. So how appropriate. Anyway, I'm gonna have some music in the background so I can wiggle around a little bit while I'm soaping, because that's what I love to do. I haven't made soap in a while. I've been messing around a lot with embeds. I've got some really cute embed molds, and I've been playing around with those with glycerin soap, but it's kind of, you know, it's funny, making soap is like riding a bike. You never forget, but you know, when it's been a while, you do kind of get off track, so bear with me. I'm sure I'm going to dork out at some point. I already did with one thing, and getting everything ready, but hopefully I got everything I need, and so anyway, let's go on for this ride. So I've got my oils and clay and colloidal oatmeal and other goodies going on in here. And my water is ready. I got the camera good enough. I put it up higher than I normally do, so hopefully it'll should zoom out a little bit. Anyway. I think I'll have time to mess. The cool thing is with this one, I'm just doing a single colored base. So, you know, I'm not going to do anything fancy because I just basically want it to kind of look like water, just plain blue water. So that's pretty easy. Please don't fall. I always dread that happening. Okay, let's get this mixed up. I've been messing with my main recipe just a little bit. Nothing too crazy, but, you know, I've been kind of adding goodies here and there and changing some things up a little bit, but, so really these soaps are kind of experimental. Those of you that know me know I hate testing soap. I'd rather just make a loaf, so if it turns out good, then cool. anyway, so let's see. I'm going to do a piped top, so I need to, good Lord, Mel, get the camera going here. Excuse me while I move you around. Well, that didn't do much, but okay, I'm going to wiggle you around here so I can get this. I have a flip screen and I want to be able to see it the correct way. Okay. So, what I need to do is get this poured into these two. This one I'm just going to do some white for the top. I don't need a horrible amount. The rest, boy, I might go ahead and mix the main part in here since I'm not doing anything fancy. Yeah, we'll just do that. Keep it easy. Okay, let's get some blue mixed in here. This is just blue mica from a supplier where I used to live. I think I probably just put way too much in there, but that's okay. I hate it when it puffs up like that. Okay. peed probably a little bit in the shower or whatever, but not a big deal. Pretty blue. Okay. So I'm going to dump all of the fragrance oil in here because I don't want to put any in the white top. Which I should add more titanium dioxide. I'm just going to add it to this. You're not missing anything fancy. Because I want that really white. Now that I got blue all over my stick blender. Should have done the white first, but that's okay. It doesn't matter horribly if this sets up too much. This fragrance does actually work pretty well, so I'm not too worried about it, but okay, I think what I'll do actually, I've got another blender here I could probably get away with using for the white. And I bought a spare too, so I have actually three. This one works really strongly, even on low, so it's louder. Gee, it kind of helps if it's plugged in. Okay. Pardon my arm here. Hate this bottle. It's noisy and it gets tons of bubbles and I really do not like it. But boy, if you want a good like smoothie blender or something, hand mixer. Yeah, look at all those bubbles. Hate it. Drives me crazy. And that's on low, people. Okay, I'm going to call that good because I just really hate to use that thing. So I might whip out the other one I got is like this one, so I might whip that out and just use that as a second one when I'm soaping. So I do want this to thicken up. I have a feeling I'm going to have to pause the video and wait for this to thicken up, which is fine. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and get this poured in here. Sure, I'm gonna like that camera, you know, angle where it's at, but I just don't feel like messing with it right now. Yeah, see that I'm doing this hand blender on high and it's not obnoxious, so this is a really good one. It's a Hamilton Beach, so I really like it. It's got a lower what they call it, agitation rate or speed, whatever, but I just like it because it's not overly powerful. That other one is insane. But it'd be really good, like I said, if you're mixing drinks. Look at this. This is great. I have tons of time. I could mess with this. One thing I did that I dorked on earlier was the sodium lactate. So I don't have much in here, which I love to use it. So I was quite irritated with myself for screwing that part up. But that's all right. Can't be perfect all the time, right? Do with this is just pour it in. Nothing fancy, nothing special. I mean, look how loose that still is. I love it. If you're doing like swirling or all kinds of fancy stuff, but of course the one time I'm not is when it's nice and loose. I'm literally just pouring the blue in. Isn't that life? It's never easy on us. Okay. Some stuff kind of cleaned up here. And you know, when I soap, I realize just how anal retentive I am. I mean, it's ridiculous. I sit here and, like, you know, heaven forbid anything get messy. I mean, isn't that what soaping's all about, is making a mess and having fun like a child? You would think so. But, for some strange reason, I catch myself over-cleaning, which is ridiculous. But, the thing that makes it nice is, in the end, I don't have a huge mess, because I've already kind of done some cleaning throughout it. Screaming bird. Apologize. No one's being choked. It's just a bird. But let me tell you, sometimes there's a lot of bubbles in this. Look how fluid that is. Yummy, yummy. Okay, get that out of the way. Wipe my hands off. And like I said, this white top is going to be a while. I'm going to smack this down. It's going to be extremely obnoxious. And I really don't want to do this because it makes the line up along the side. And I really don't like that. One thing I found that works really good for wiping the edge like that is like a little paring knife. You literally can just like run it down the side and it gets most of it off. It's pretty easy to use. I did get the, okay, I obviously can't do it very well at that angle. I did much worse. I did get these molds in the, I guess they call them clear or white, whatever. I have them. I just haven't opened them up and cleaned them to use them and everything, so these were ready to go. I just cleaned them up real quick and figured I'd use them. But boy, I do like the other ones because I think it'll be neat to be able to see through the sides because I'm extremely impatient. Ask my husband. He'll tell you. I like, you know, I want to see like the sides, what it's looking like, and to, you can't really do that much, obviously with these at all. So anyway, I am going to have to hit pause and kind of work with this a little bit, see if I can get it to, thicken up nice and good for me. And I'm not going to use this blender because it's just too obnoxiously strong. So anyway, guys, yeah. Done with you today. Okay, guys, I started, let's see if I can get this, might zoom in just a bit. This piping is still pretty loose, but what I did is I put on a round tip, since the theme of this is bath time, I thought I'd try to do some circles, like bubbles. And it seems to be working okay, even though, like I said, the soap's still pretty wet or loose. I don't know how this is going to set up, but I figured I'd give it a try. What the heck. It's keeping peaks a little bit. If anything, I'm worried I might run out. I thought maybe I had used too much, but I don't think that's the case. So we'll see how it goes, and if a little bit of the blue shows through on the bottom, that's cool. I'm okay with that. I was thinking about doing some like, you know, swirling the blue in with the white, but then I thought, nah. And you'll see why, because of what I'm putting on the top. Boy, I am cutting it close. I usually tend to use too much for, you know, reserve too much for the top, but of course this time it wasn't that case. I was just going to do a blob down the middle so you could see the blue on the sides, and then I thought, well, I kind of wanted to try this hole. Technique, but the other thing too with this recipe, I'm going to run out here. I'm going to do, it just shot out. See, that's what I hate about it being so thin. But, why is it? I always just get so lucky. That's good. So I'm going to take my gloves off. What I'm going to do is, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Because of the size of this batch, I was messing with, you know, sizes of the recipe. And I think what I'm going to do is like 8 bars. Because when I figured it out, I don't like the bars to be too small. That's one thing I don't like. So these are cute. They're little, I can't tell if it's focusing or not. The viewfinder's on the other side of the camera and I can't get around it. It's a little soap. This is a soap. It says soap on it. And then the bottom part is a little soap dish. So I thought these were just too adorable. So what I did is made those, and then I made little soap bubbles. out of just a round mold. And those are barely going to fit in there. Yeah, see that piped top is a little thin. I'm already getting soap on these. Okay, so blue, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wow, so I really need to spread those out. So we'll start going this way with them. Try not to get it all over my hands. These might be herking bars. I don't know why I just gotta bug up my, you know what, to kind of mess with the recipe, but I'm a little on the ADD side. Like, I get bored with things. And 2, 3, 4. So I started messing with my recipe. I didn't need to. I just, like I said, something to do. Not that I don't have enough to do. Don't we all feel like we have too much to do all the time? But they'll squish down in there a little bit. Gosh darn it. Why do I keep doing that? Poor little soapy. Okay. I never shake unless I do embeds. It is the weirdest thing to me. I'm not a shaky kind of person. I'm not a nervous person. I'm not one of those twitchy people. But when I do embeds, I shake. Probably because I like perfection too much. And these embeds were made with just silicone molds. Good Lord, I think I'm getting more on my fingers. Okay, so two more, and I went a little too far. Oops. Maybe I'll scoot them all just a little bit. Make them more even. My little bubbles are going deep into the soap. It still looks cute though, the white whipped soap looks, or topping looks cute. Still maintaining a bit of fluff. Turn it sideways, make sure I got them all straight. Grr. Okay, cute. And now what I'm gonna do is take this iridescent glitter. Oh, actually, I forgot. I was going to just put a few of these little blue sugar balls. That'll make it cute. Okay, cute. I was thinking about doing white ones too, but boy, I don't even know if they'll really show up. They're supposed to kind of mimic bubbles, but you know what? Bubble bath and stuff usually has kind of colors in it, and the soap can give the effect of rainbow colors, so I will go ahead and do yellow too. Since we're already playing with yellow and it. And those are probably going to drag when I cut the soap, but that's okay. Just flip it on its side and hope that it's not too bad. And now for the glitter. To give that effect of the rainbow colors, all soft and iridescent like that you see in bubble bath. Too cute. I am liking that soap. So, this is bubble bath soap. And I hope you enjoyed. Have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.